Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. And from time to time, I get a doctor that comes to me that's kind of freaking out about a midline and they're wanting to use elastics. And I'm like, whoa, pump the brakes. Let's just take it one step at a time. And you need to approach your clear aligner, Invisalign, or ClearCorrect cases just like you do a braces case. And that initially, you're going to do level and align. Now, you need to have some idea of how these midlines are going to migrate while you level and align. And usually, I have somewhat of an idea. But nowadays, with the Invisalign in-face outcome simulator, which is different than the iTero outcome simulator. And if you're not sure what that is, you can go into our channel, search that by keyword. It really puts that midline right in front of you, which is, in order to use that, watch the videos I have on how to opt into it. But it's pretty powerful. But now you guys are wanting to do some crazy stuff with midlines on the front end. And I'm like, you know, this is just based on AI. And how much do you really trust the AI of this computer and of this operating system? Because I don't fully trust it yet. So how about we just straighten the teeth? And then there's going to be a point where you're probably going to need a refinement. And then we can always double track the midline then. And the main midline I want to know is the upper midline. Lower one I can always move around if I need to later. Easy. Upper one's kind of important. So let's find out where that is. Let's get that on at the beginning on the Clincheck, on the clear pilot setup. The other thing that comes up often is you start to see a little bit of a posterior open bite during treatment, but everything's tracking and the ClinCheck or clear pilot setup looks like it's reasonable. Well, in that case, I don't always get that worried. I mean, obviously, if the patient is a crazy Brux or a clincher, we might need to consider some Masseter or Botox. And if we don't already have anterior bite turbos on the case, now's probably a good time to refine and put those on. But assuming that neither of those are the issues, and we already have the bite turbos, I'm seeing a tiny itty-bitty, not like raging case of posterior open bite, it's probably just due to interference, and this is just normal. I like to look at the teeth. If they're not straight and they're not done yet, I'm not worried, as long as they are tracking. If they're not tracking, that's a different story. So just like I do in braces cases, little things like this, like integrating the bite and lower midline, I don't deal with until the third stage of braces. And let's talk about the stage of braces again. Number one, level and align. Number two, space closure and bite correction. And number three, finishing and detailing, which often isn't even done anymore because if you put the braces on right with indirect bonding, you really shouldn't have finishing and detailing. Or maybe you'll just finish and detail with some bonded wires and let the bite settle. All right, hopefully that was helpful. Take care.